we know that God is light. God is spirit. God is the supreme being, the supreme soul, the seed of the universe, the bodiless one, the source, the force, the ocean of love and compassion. God is not a human, neither male nor female. God is a discarnate being, the highest intelligence, aware of everyone and everything. God is beyond gender.
The original relationship. Taking just a minute, I come to my home. I see the Supreme Soul, a radiant point of energy. I am his child, his friend. He calls. I come closer. I feel nurtured, cherished. I feel safe, loved. The one who is pure love accepts me as I am. All fears and disappointments melt. He whispers through a thought. With every breath, through every storm, just take my hand and hold on. Use my strength and move on. This sacred friendship embraces me through all eternity. Remembering. Taking just a minute, I sit quietly and reflect on who I am, who I really am. I begin to remember, begin to feel the original goodness, an intrinsic positivity that somehow had been forgotten. In the quietness, remembering this original spiritual selfhood, peace and respect begin to flow. Feeling restored, rejuvenated, I return, recharged to the outer world of sound and action.
Known by many names, the Divine, God, Supreme, Allah, and yet for the soul, it is the one eternal parent. I become aware of my eternal self. I open up to draw power from the supreme source. I, the soul, stay connected, and God's rays of peace reach out into the universe, embracing all. The ocean of peace, the ocean of love, envelops all souls of the world in peace and love, soothing, embracing, healing, and rejuvenating. God is one.
Prepare myself to be in the company of God, the Supreme amongst all souls, ever pure, ever powerful, ever loving, and the one who is most loved by all. I reaffirm my identity as an elevated being. I remove the cloak of my human form, revealing my light. I am spirit. A soul, a beautiful, sparkling life energy, tiny and concentrated, a jewel of light. Within this body, I exist in the center of my forehead. Behind my eyes, I am eternal. Immortal. My body will die, but I am immortal. I come from the world of souls, my home, where God is ever present, waiting for me to reach out, reach upward. A being of light. And I am a companion of God, the light of the world. The power of God's love. I sense you. Just above me, and your light is showering down on me, like a fountain of light, washing over me. I bathe in your light. I feel it spreading through me, restoring my peace and equilibrium. Waves of your light are shining upon me, nurturing me. Slowly, gently, I allow my awareness to return to my body.
What is the divine source, the ultimate energy that restores us and gives us all our power and qualities? Now, let us reconnect and direct our minds above and beyond to the source. We have been calling the divine by many names: God, Jehovah, Allah, Shiva, Shanti. We have built churches, gurudwaras, temples, and mosques to God, and carved statues to represent the divine. We have even waged wars in the name of God. We performed so many sacrifices. We thought God is to be found in nature or in the sky. Then we thought that God is everywhere. Whenever we suffer, we call out to God for relief. But when we are happy again, we forget. We worshipped God as a human form, but at the same time, we don't know him. Prophets and teachers tried to point the way to the divine, but yet no one has reached. In fact, God is our father and our mother. God is ours in all relationships. God can never be born like us, nor can the divine ever die. But God is the eternal light, the tiniest, most subtle point of invisible light. God is invisible to our material eyes, and we too are subtle beings like points of light. God dwells forever in the world of stillness and peace. We were once there too, in that golden silence. Then we came to the earth. We were born into our bodies and began to live our own stories. With the passage of time, we forgot our home, and we forgot God. Now, God has returned to tell us who we are, and to show us the secrets of time. God has come again to fill us with all the love, power and peace that we had lost for so long. Remember, remember, remember.
I reaffirm my identity as an elevated being. I remove the cloak of my human form, revealing my light. I am spirit. I am a soul, a beautiful, sparkling life energy, tiny and concentrated, a jewel of light. Within this body, I exist in the center of my forehead, behind my eyes. Life energy surrounds my body in an aura of light. In my daily life, my memory of this lapses, so I remind myself, I am eternal. I am immortal. My body will die, but I am immortal. And I have journeyed through time for more than this one short life. I am not of this world. I come from the world of souls, my home, where God is ever present, waiting for me to reach out, reach upward. I attune myself once more to higher planes, greater pursuits. I am an elevated soul. A being of light. And I am a companion of God, the light of the world. I accept my role as a helper of God. I become a channel for God's vibrations into this world. Powerful vibrations. Healing vibrations. The power of God's love. I sense you just above me, and your light is showering down on me like a fountain of light, washing over me. Feel it spreading through me, restoring my peace and equilibrium. Your light chases away the shadows within me. Your light and might gives me the courage to face all obstacles, weather all storms. Waves of your light. Fill me with your light. Your light uplifts me. Your power comes into me and through me. For your light and love.
name.